Another one that has been tearing away of late has been Dish TV. Salil Kapoor, the COO of Dish TV, joins us now to talk more about the business of the company and how it's been shaping up of late. Salil, hi, morning. Thanks so much for joining us on the show. Just first, a word on these developments in the first week of March about the entertainment tax being waived from Rajasthan for DTH operators. It's about 10% of the revenues. Can you tell us what kind of an impact this would really have on the business?
It's not 10% of the overall revenues, it's just 10% of the entertainment tax that's been waived off from Rajasthan. The overall incidence of entertainment tax, you know, varies across various states from 5 to 25%. So it's one state which has had this progressive decision during their budget. So I think the government there has actually been able to look at the issues of the people on ground. Watching TV should not be taxed because it's not only entertainment, it's also a source of information. So we look forward to more UPA-led states with this kind of progressive thinking to waive off the entertainment tax.
Salil, morning. So how big is Rajasthan for you as a market, and what kind of material impact would it have for you?
It's a marginal impact as of now. Rajasthan has about a base of about 6 lakhs out of our total 10 million subscribers, so not very significant. However, the market is growing fast there. The growth rates are very good. What I think the impact will be, more states picking up this point, and when they wave it off, the overall incidence of 8 to 9% of entertainment tax, which we pay all over as a part of our total subscription revenue, that might get affected. With one state, it's not great difference, but it's a good beginning.
How's growth trends been generally, Salil, for Q4? What kind of sub ad do you think you'll end with?
We should do 1.1 million plus. We had this forecast of, we'd given the guidance for about 2.5 million for this year against 1.8 million subscribers for last fiscal. Then we revised it from 2.5 million to 3 million. And then I think we will end up by 3.5 million gross ads plus. It's been a good year with a lot of cricket. It's been a good year with good Diwali. And I think the cricket is now going into the early part of the next fiscal as well. So the going is good. Especially our launch of high definition channels. We have about 30 channels on a high definition. We are the only DTH platform to have those channels. That will also have impact on overall subscriber growth.
Could you give us any numbers on that front? What could the subscriber addition be for the next couple of months, not just for overall, but even in the premium HD segment?
HD, we think next year we will be able to add about 3.5 million subscribers again, and out of that, minimum 10%. I said minimum 10%, and it could be more than that, will be high definition subscribers. The difference that we have in our offering is highly differentiated vis-a-vis competition. So there has been a lot of positive response from the market as well from the trade. We had, before launch of 30 channels, we had every day about, say, 100 ads on high definition, and post the launch we've seen the number has grown up to 1000 plus, so it's 10x growth after the launch of 30 HD channels. So going forward, we think it's going to be further growing. So as I said, minimum 10% plus subscribers will come from this premium segment.
The reason I asked you specifically about the high definition subscriber segment is because there's been a lot of excitement about how that segment would really add on to your operating performance because of the higher ARPUs that HD enjoys. Can you tell us what kind of ARPUs are you expecting from that segment in the next couple of quarters, and subsequently how would that help in your EBITDA performance?
You'll have to do the maths on translating the numbers. I'll give you some base numbers. Our ARPU is around 142. The last quarter when we announced it was about 142. The HD subscriber pays minimum 450 rupees, and while we are adding more and more a la carte, and we've grown from 5 channel to 30 channel now, the ARPU potential is high there. And when I'm saying that it will be 10% or the total contribution for next year's gross ads, that is only for those that year gross ads, it's not over the overall base, so one can do the maths. So there will be improvement, but not very, very substantial. But it slowly needs to grow, and that's what we see as a net effect. So there's great positive effect on ARPU as well.
How's market share been trending for you, Salil, especially with the Cricket World Cup quarter underway?
It's about 31-32%, and we've seen some good positive growth from cricket coming in the during the World Cup. Today is a crucial match for India, and if India enters into semis, we look forward to further growth coming up in those numbers. And then of course there is the IPL excitement from April onwards. So good, more cricket, more TV, more DTH.
And what do you think you can get on track to do in the next financial year in terms of subscriber additions, even in terms of a percentage growth over your current rate?
We are planning to have another gross adds of about 3.5 million, something very similar to what we have done in this year. We feel that the industry will again add a similar number, which is about 13 to 14 million, and we should do about 3.5 million out of that.
Thanks, Alan, for joining in. That's Dish TV saying minimal impact from news that's coming from Rajasthan. Should tweak margins around a little bit, but still not a huge market for them. The stock itself is holding up okay. The